Today I'm drinking Clifford Brewing Porter Company's Porter. They call it a strong beer, 5.9%, I guess so. It's got a nice roasted malt taste. I like that. They are from Hamilton, Ontario, so you'd probably be able to get this elsewhere in the country, unlike some of these Manitoba beers that I normally have, just because other provinces don't like to import for whatever reason. Lots of mail today, as usual. Well, I pulled five pieces out, but I got a nice big one and a couple of fairly well-stuffed packs, so let's get at it. The first thing says adhesive rubber feet, which is entirely possible to be a correct and accurate what's going on here? Feels like two packages of them. Okay. Or two packages anyways. Yes, it is. Little rubber sticky back feet. 3M electronics. Either legitimately or, you know, somebody's just cloning their logo. But yeah. Little round rubber feet. And are these the same ones or did I order something? Did I maybe order two different sizes or something here? Ah. I ordered some clear ones and some white ones. Okay. Well, those will come in handy for little project cases that I don't want to skate around. Actually, I could probably put some on the bottom of this one, because right now all it's got is the screws sticking out that are holding it together. 100 pieces, black self-adhesive rubber feet, semicircle bumpers, door buffer A. From Little Apple 2014. Currently they're selling them for $2.22 Canadian. I paid $1.77. And the clear ones, 100 pieces self-adhesive silicone feet, bumpers, door, cupboard, drawer, cabinet, Kitc. Also Little Apple 2014. Currently they're selling them for $2.10 Canadian. I paid $1.59. And I don't think I paid shipping back at that point in time. So not much to see down here. Just the size, 8 by 2.5 millimeters. And same thing for the black ones, just these ones are a soft polyurethane, the black ones it says. And the clear ones are silicone, although they didn't feel very different to me, but whatever. They'll do the job. Yeah, that is quite nice. Next, phone accessories, it says. Oh, come on, get out of there. What is this hiding under this film here? Okay. It's got a battery compartment on the back for triple A's and a little switch here. So what happens if you put batteries in it? Assuming that these are not dead. Okay. It lights up. I think these batteries might be dead though. That's pretty dim. Well, that's embarrassing. I don't seem to have any batteries that are in good shape, or at least any triple A's. So that is the negative. Put 3 volts on my power supply here. That is the positive. Okay. Dim, medium, and bright. Okay, and I think I figured out what this thing is too. It's a ring light that clips over your phone, goes over your phone with the camera through there to light up the subject that you're taking pictures of.
Portable selfie LED ring fill camera flash for mobile phone iPhone 1 pieces. The seller that I bought it from was Bestseller 1-1, but they don't have it anymore. So we'll just look at the listings here. I got it for $214 with free shipping. I think it was an auction. It seemed like an interesting thing to play with. Here is just a random listing from somebody. They're available black, white, pink, blue. Pair of AAA batteries. Material plastic, duh. 3 brightness levels, 36 long-lasting LED bulbs, convenient to use, designed with anti-slip and anti-scratch resistant sponge.
Sponge?
I mean, it's not that difficult to see how it should work. Mine doesn't look as bright as they imply it there. Maybe you're just supposed to look at the girls and not pay attention to that. I don't know.
So here's how it installs. That's it. There is no step two. The downside is that it kind of obscures your view a little bit. That shimmering on the screen is not to do with this thing. That's just why my wife doesn't use this phone anymore. But yeah, it kind of blocks a little bit of the screen. So let's go play with it with my phone here, and we'll see what we can find, see what it looks like. Okay, it's not quite so well lit over in this corner here, plus I'm casting a shadow. So let's clip this on and... Oh! Okay, so it's not quite universal for all cameras. Fine. I'm just going to clip it onto the top of my phone. It's right up there now. So, low brightness, medium, high brightness. Actually, that's not bad. That cancels out a lot of the shadows that I was casting. Okay. That's not bad at all, actually. I was expecting it to be crappier. So let's drop down to, there's off, low, medium, high brightness. That's not bad at all. Huh, I was expecting it to be much more horrible. I think I can live with that. Okay, next in we have TPU material. I wonder what a TPU is. Little plastic pellets. Did it say plastic sheet? No. I think I know what this is. Let's just go check the listing and we'll see if I'm right.
DIY 50 grams hand moldable thermoplastic polymorph friendly plastic pellets craft. I got this from Yankee87, and I got it at auction for $1.99 Canadian with free shipping. It's they've got it on regular sale right now, or regular price right now, for $2.26. Now, this stuff is kind of interesting. It claims to be able to soften at about 60 degrees Celsius so that you can mold it kind of like soft, transparent clay, and then when it you shape it, and when it cools back off, it solidifies. I first heard about this from in this video by Electronics and More. I'll put a link to it. He used it for electrical insulation and a few other things, and suggested a few other ideas in this video. So I want to try it for a couple of different reasons, and I'm just going to do one little experiment right now, and then we'll try it with better experiments later on at some point in the future. Okay, so I've got a little glass of just hot tap water. I can just barely hold my finger in it, so that maybe that's hot enough. We'll see. I don't want these things to go all over the place and disappear. Try to open it a little bit. Let's pour a few of them into there. That's probably enough for an experiment. And then where's something to stir it with? Coffee stir stick. Anything softening? Not really. That might not be hot enough. Because, you know, you don't want tap water kept too hot. Okay. Let's just scoop them out onto my piece of masonite here. I think I'll try and heat them just with the heat gun and see if that'll work. That video that I showed you a little bit of suggested heating them in boiling water, so maybe that's what I need rather than just hot water. No, they're not falling apart any. They're not boiling on too much. They're starting to get a little bit transparent. And it says these are hand moldable, which means that I should be able to put my hands on them to mold them, right?
That's not too bad. Okay, they're kind of sticky. They remind me a little bit of hot melt glue, actually. So, I've got a little mold here that I made for years ago for HO scale stuff. So I'm just going to press some of this into there. One of these mold voids is, I think, a crate of bottles or something like that. And the other two are crates of fruit or something. So, yeah, that softens fairly well. So I'll press some of that into there and just see what happens. And then as one other experiment, I've got this mold for a ladder. I don't know whether that'll work or not. It's got pretty skinny details on it, but we'll give it a shot. What's the worst that could happen? We just have to remelt this stuff into something else, I guess. Let's press this down. So these are kind of a silicone rubber molds that I made a long time ago just using some stuff from a craft store. Okay, so I'm just gonna let those chill for a while and I'll be back in a minute to see what they look like. Meanwhile, let's see what this is. A module. Okay, always like a good module. Looks like an Arduino Nano or something. It does look like one, doesn't it? What does it say on the back here? It says LGTBF328P Nano 3 compatible. Nano 3? Yeah, it looks like all the usual pins, a regulator, what is that, serial... Holtec HT45B534. Is that a USB to serial chip? Possibly. What is this? It appears not to want to tell us what it is. On the back, it definitely said 328P, but LGT8F. The other thing I don't see on the front of this thing is a crystal or a resonator. So what's it doing for timing? I better go and take a look and see what this is, really.
One piece LGT8F328P-LQFP32 MiniEVB for Arduino Nano 3.0 HT42B534-1. That's the serial chip. Replace ATMEG328P. I assume they mean ATMEGA328P. This I got from CCTV 008008. Another one of these that just rolls off the tongue. It was only $2.46, which makes it about the same price or a little bit cheaper than an Arduino Nano these days. They don't seem to have a description down here, but I after doing a bit of looking around, I remember I heard about this from Ralph Bacon. He looked at this thing in one of his videos a few months back. I'll put a link to that video up in the top right corner. But more importantly, it's faster than an ATMEGA328. I'll play with this thing at some point in the future and probably do a video. But in the meantime, Ralph probably explains it better than I can anyway. So go check out his video.
And the last thing in, the biggest package. Notice how I always save the biggest package for last? I hope it makes a good finale here. Whatever it is, it's in a crushed box, which doesn't want to open well. This is a kil-a-watt type power meter thing, so that'll make it easier for me to test out AC powered stuff. Power meter monitoring testing equipment. Install nickel metal hydride rechargeable batteries. 3.6 volt. What? You see any battery compartment? Oh, it's already powered on. Okay. Get that out of the way. Up, down, cost per kilowatt, function, kilowatt hours, volts, amps, watts. Oh, okay. So, let's, what does it say in the back here? Sure, let's do that. 60 hertz, 110 to 130 volts, 120 C, nominal, max 15 amps, wattage 0 to 1800, will display 0 to 15, price per kilowatt hours. Yeah. It claims to be Intertech certified. Don't really believe it when I bought it from China. It claims to be Cat 2 rated. You never know. I'm not going to use this. Leave this thing running unattended, though.
TS836A plug power meter energy watt voltage amps meter with electricity US version QK41. I got this from GabSweezero. I didn't pay $49.99 for it, though I paid $12.77 for it. And but they don't sell it anymore. This is just the archived listing. So I'm going to link to a list there to this search, which finds a bunch of them. And for a much more reasonable price than what that guy is currently asking for it to. But anyway, what does it say here? Measures power, energy, volts, amps, hertz, power factor, and maximum power. Time, days, kilowatt hours, yada yada. Okay. It has an overload warning, cumulative monitors, yeah. Material, metal, and plastic. For the US plug, US and Canada.
Okay, I've gathered up a few things to play with this thing and a little power source to plug it into here. So, first thing that happens when we plug it in is it just shows up with all zeros, so we can bang through the screens here. First of all, voltage 123.6 volts currently in my basement, 60 hertz expected. Then we have the amps and power factor screen. Then we have the low wattage. Basically, it does a max and min recording of wattage over time. So there's a low and there's a high, and that's cost per kilowatt hour. And there is just straight watts with the actual cost. I'm not going to bother putting in the cost because that's not why I bought this thing. And then total kilowatt hours, and that top is duration that it's had a load being drawn in hours, minutes, and days. And we're back to voltage again. I'm going to plug in a, what do we got here? A 60 watt incandescent bulb. So that should show up. It's pretty close to 60 watts. Yeah, 62.9 watts. That's just about perfect. And voltage hasn't sagged, which is good. Half an amp, which is pretty close. 120 volts, 60 watts, right? Low and high wattage. And where's the amperage? Yeah. And a power factor of 1.0, which is what you expect off an incandescent bulb. Let me replace that with an LED bulb. Let me replace it specifically with this 12-watt, 100 milliamp sunbeam bulb, which is a dollar store bulb, so it's not going to be the best one in the world, but we'll see what it does. Okay, so that is showing 11.2 watts, which is just about perfect. The voltage hasn't changed. 0.94 power factor, 97 milliamps, which is pretty close to what it claimed. That's a surprisingly good power factor for an LED bulb. Let's find something with a crappier power factor. There's got to be something around here. How about this really horrible USB charger that I tore down a while back? Some of you may remember that our friend Diodes Gone Wild has looked at this one and declared it as super dodgy. So plug him in, and it's drawing about 7 watts, 7.3 watts. It's got a 1 amp load on the 5 volts right now. And a power factor of 0.6, which is still higher than I expected for something this crappy, but that's, you know, and 99 milliamps. Yeah, that's about right. So now let's try something a little bit more powerful. This is a portable electric space heater. which you may hear running. So that's drawing 3 and a quarter amps. And that's on its low setting. Where's watts? 525, 530 watts. I'll click it up to its high setting, which kicks in some more coil, heating coils. 829, 880. It should get pretty close to 1,000 watts here. Yeah, so bump up to amps. It's actually got a 1 amp power factor. It's got a brushless AC motor and a bunch of big resistive heating coils. So I guess, yeah, the heating coils are probably just creating that. That one exact, that perfect one power factor, 13.7. Yeah, and my ankles are getting hot, so I'm going to turn that off. So, is this going to be a perfect tool? Probably not, and I'll have to do some more tests and compare it against compare its current against an AC ammeter that I've got here. That's a more accurate instrument, but in the meantime, this will do quite nicely. One other thing that I've noticed, the only way to get that running time and the kilowatt hours and the other stuff to clear is by pushing that little reset button there, which needs something skinny like a DuPont wire. And there is the items from today's mailbag. Quite a wide assortment and not nearly as electronic as I often do. Oh, I forgot to check those molds. Hang on, they're just over here. Let's see how those came out. That took the detail not too bad. You can kind of see the detail of the items in the crates. If I paint that up, that probably won't look too bad. How about the ladder? Obviously there's some flash to trim off, but that's going to happen no matter what you stuff in a mold. That ladder came out not too bad. Obviously, again, some cleanup, but... Actually, I'm going to take just a second and clean that ladder up. Hang on. Okay, I got the ladder cleaned up, sort of. I didn't spend hours and hours on it, and I made a mistake, which I repaired. So I think it looks not too bad for something that fine, and it came out okay. I'm probably not going to use this stuff for making molds of stuff, but partly because the cleanup's a bit of a pain in the ass. But, yeah, right here I cut through it accidentally, so I just turned my heat gun on it for just a second and remelted it and reformed it back into a ladder. But still, as if this was in the background or in a junk pile or something, that ladder would look perfectly acceptable as a model. So I'm happy with how that works for fine details, and I should be able to mold just about anything I need out of that stuff. That could be an interesting craft material for future reference. Anyway, shipping times for this stuff. These thermoplastic pellets took 2.5 months for no apparent reason. The ring light took 7.5 weeks. The rubber feet took 18 days? Wow. This interesting little... What do you want to call it? Nano 3, I guess it says in the back of it. But that uses the different higher speed chip. That took a month to get here. That'll be interesting to play with at some point. And this kilowatt knockoff power meter thing took 1 month exactly. So, yeah, there we go. I hope you enjoyed that. Thanks for watching. Thanks, as always, to my Patreon supporters for funding this foolishness. I really do appreciate you guys, and I see I got one more today, so thank you for that. Yeah, I guess that's everything. Thanks for watching. Comments and questions down below, as usual. I will talk to you later.